गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, कैसे हैं आप सब? आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट बैंकिंग अवेयरनेस पार्ट टू एमसीक्यूज। आई हैव ऑलरेडी टॉट यू पार्ट वन एमसीक्यूज एंड यू विल गेट लिंक ऑफ दैट क्लास इन द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन। जॉइन माई टेलीग्राम चैनल फ्रॉम दिस लिंक। यू विल गेट डेली प्रैक्टिस पीडीएफ्स ऑफ क्वांट्स, रीजनिंग एंड इंग्लिश फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट फ्रॉम दिस चैनल। You will also get daily vocabulary and current affairs there. You can join this channel from this link. And if you have not subscribed this channel, please subscribe this channel for the upcoming videos. And if you join this Telegram channel, you will get links of all the upcoming videos. So join both Telegram channel as well as YouTube channel. So we are going to start with our first question of the day. That is, who is the current head of Central Registry Securitization Asset Reconstruction and Security Interest? The options are Praveen Kumar Sharma, Naveen Kumar Sharma, Lakshmi Nivas Mittal, Nandan Nilekalan. You have to guess the answer. And the right answer is, you are seeing here in the option, Praveen Kumar Sharma. I am going to explain your answer. CERSAI is a central online security interest registry of India. It was primarily created to check frauds in lending against equitable mortgages, in which people would take multiple loans on the same asset from different banks. It was founded on March 11, 2011 and is headed by Praveen Kumar Sharma. Our next question is, you can see here our next question, question number 12. Where does the headquarters of Brickwork Ratings India Private Limited situated? The options are Bangalore, Hyderabad, Mumbai or New Delhi. Yes, guess the answer please. If you don't know the answer, I am going to show you the answer here. The answer is Bangalore. Brickwork Ratings India Private Limited is headquartered in Bangalore. This credit rating agency is responsible to rate bank loans, municipal corporation, capital market, instrument and SMEs. SMEs are, you have to write the full form of SMEs in comment section. Listen, you have to read this description of the answer also. The question can come from this description, like credit rating agency is responsible for what? For rate bank loans, municipal corporation, capital market instrument and SMEs. So our next question is, yes, please read the next question here. The first introduction of mutual funds in India occurred in which of the following years? 1964, 1963, 1987, 1999. And the answer is, can you guess the answer before I show you the answer? The answer is 1963. The first introduction of a mutual fund in India occurred in 1963 when the government of India launched Unit Trust of India, UTI, Unit Trust of India, enjoyed a monopoly in the Indian mutual fund market until 1987. You have to remember the year 1987. And it occurred in the year 1963. Till 1987, UTI, Unit Trust of India, enjoyed monopoly in the Indian mutual fund market. Our next question is, yes, here is the question number 14. Which of the following is the situation when the units of a close-ended fund can be bought? I repeat the question. Which of the following is the situation when the units of a close-ended fund can be bought? The options are at the launch, at any time, at redemption, depends upon the fund type. So can you guess the answer? Yes, this is the answer. The answer is at the launch. In a closed-end fund, a fixed number of shares are offered by an investment company through an initial public offering. They can be bought only at the launch of the fund. सो द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, यस, क्वेश्चन नंबर 15, व्हेन डिड द प्राइवेट कंपनीज गॉट द परमिशन टू सेट अप म्यूचुअल फंड्स? व्हेन डिड द प्राइवेट कंपनीज गॉट द परमिशन टू सेट अप म्यूचुअल फंड्स? द ऑप्शन आर 1992, 1993, 1994 और द 1982. यस, प्लीज गेस द आंसर. एंड द आंसर इज, यस, यू कैन सी हियर द आंसर, 1992. In 1992, private companies also got permission to set up mutual funds and SEBI mutual funds. Regulation 1993 provides guidelines for registration, constitution, management and schemes of mutual funds in India. In 1992, private companies also got permission to set up mutual funds and SEBI mutual funds. Regulation, this is the Act 1993. Provide guidelines for registration, constitution, management and schemes of mutual funds. The question can come from here, like the private companies got permission to set up mutual funds under which act? And the act is under which act? Yes, tell me, under which act? Under the SEBI Regulation 1993. This is the name of the act. Next question. Yes, please read the question. Yes, mutual funds in India are permitted to invest in which of the following? Mutual funds have permission to invest which in the following, like securities, securities and gold, securities other than real estate, securities, gold and real estate. And the right option is, yes, right option is securities, gold and real estate. Mutual fund can invest in all of these, securities, gold, real estate. Mutual funds in India are permitted to invest in security, gold and real estate. A mutual fund is prohibited from investing in any unlisted security or a security issued through private placement by an associate or a group company of the sponsor. So our next question is, here is the question number 17. Which of the following countries has the largest mutual fund market in the world? Here are the options, USA, Japan, China or Brazil. So please guess the answer. Can you guess the answer in between of these? USA, Japan, China or Brazil? Yes, the right answer is here. What is the answer? The answer is USA. The country with the largest mutual fund industry in United States. It has an amount of $18.9 trillion. Mutual fund assets worldwide is approximately $40.4 trillion. Here you have to remember these terms, because in banking awareness the examiner can ask these terms. Okay, the next question is question number 18. So please read this question. Which bank has the lowest interest rate for home loans in India? Which bank has lowest interest rate for home loans in India? The options are SBI, HDFC, ICICI, RBI. So the answer is SBI. You can easily guess from here that the private banks will not charge lowest interest. Only the government bank will charge the lowest interest. And here the government bank is SBI. RBI is the organization. And RBI, Reserve Bank of India. All the banks come under RBI. And the SBI also come under RBI. So the SBI will charge lowest interest rate for home loans in India. SBI has the lowest interest rate for the housing loans in India with a range of interest between 8.50 to 8.75% of the loan amount. Whatever the loan amount will be, the SBI will charge only 8.50 to 8.75% of the total amount or loan amount. Next question, question number 19. What is the full form of BPLR? These are the exactly the quick questions, to the point questions which can come in your exam from banking awareness point of view. सो द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ बीपीएल आर बिगनर्स प्राइम लैंडिंग रेट, बेंचमार्क प्राइम री लैंडिंग रेट, बेंचमार्क प्राइम लैंडिंग रेट और बिगनर्स प्राइम लैंडिंग रेट. ओनली द डिफरेंस ऑफ दीज वर्ड्स हियर इन द ऑप्शंस टू कंफ्यूज यू. लैंडिंग रेट आर सेम इन ऑल द ऑप्शंस. सो द आंसर इज यस, द आंसर इज सी, बेंचमार्क प्राइम लैंडिंग रेट. द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ बीपीएलआर बेंचमार्क प्राइम लैंडिंग रेट. बेंचमार्क प्राइम लैंडिंग रेट इज द रेट एट विच कमर्शियल बैंक्स चार्ज देयर कस्टमर्स हु आर मोस्ट क्रेडिट वर्दी. अकॉर्डिंग टू द रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया आरबीआई बैंक्स कैन फिक्स द बीपीएलआर विद द अप्रूवल ऑफ देयर बोर्ड. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 20. यस, हियर इज द क्वेश्चन नंबर 20. Who of the following plays the vital role in setting up of National Housing Bank? Who of the following plays the vital role in the setting of National Housing Bank? The options are K.R. Puri, Dr. Manmohan Singh, C. Rangarajan or none of the above. So, my correct answer is, yes, you are right, C. Rangarajan. C. Rangarajan is the right answer. He plays the vital role in setting National Housing Bank. A high-level group under the chairmanship of Dr. C. Rangarajan was set up under the then Deputy Governor, RBI, to examine the proposal and recommended the setting up of National Housing Bank as an autonomous housing finance institution. The recommendations of the high-level group were accepted by the Government of India. So these are the another 10 questions. I have taught you the 10 questions in the previous Banking Awareness Part 1. And these are the next 10 questions, question number 11 to 20. And you have to revise or go through from these questions also. And we will meet tomorrow in the next session or part 3 of the Banking Awareness in our next class.